Hey guys, before we start the video I wanted to give a quick shout out to a friend of mine on Roblox named Alethic. He helped me get the arachnid in Roblox jailbreak, so I wanted to thank him even though I already did in game by giving him a shout out in this video. Link for his profile in the top of the description.
A good day for me to do another collect review. Today's collect review episode is going to be dedicated to the 2000s.
The early 2000s, to be exact.
And today, we're going to be taking a look at the Nintendo GameCube.
And also,
the Gameboy Advance.
And yes, this is the first episode of the series
to be a double review. So, first off, we'll be taking a look at the Nintendo GameCube.
Now,
this I had to buy off Amazon
for about, well, not Amazon, eBay, for about
almost $70, but it was about
$60-something.
And as for the Game Boy Advance, it was about $30. So in total, it was about $90-something.
Yeah.
It's a pain, I know. And for anyone wondering if my GameCube works with the HDMI mod, or not, well, it's not necessarily a mod, it's more of an attachment that goes on the back of your GameCube. And, yes, it does. It has digital and video output. This model specifically has the digital and analog video outputs.
I don't know why I went this way. I guess because I'm looking at my camera flipped the wrong way.
And yes, this model does work specifically. It doesn't give a blinking yellow light of death or orange light. This one actually works pretty much the way you'd expect. Plug it in, power it on, and it works. Except that you need to plug in the video signal into a TV or something, which I probably don't need one because I got it.
Excuse me for a second.
Anyway, like I was saying, I don't need a TV to play my GameCube because I have this. It doesn't display the signal, but it does have a HDMI output to plug into like a monitor or something, and audio output too. Like I was saying, this will work with pretty much any device I have so far. Well, by pretty much any device, I mean only the RGB-related consoles. So if I want to convert a composite signal, I have this. And also has video, but it doesn't give me color for some reason. And as you may expect, it works perfectly well. And if I were to plug in the console card into this, then I can pretty much play any console before HDMI I1. Except for component consoles. There's no component input on this thing. However, there are transcoders that convert component to RGB SCART. This doesn't really convert composite into SCART. There's actually a composite method inside the SCART connectors themselves, or scalers, actually. The connector doesn't really do anything, it just sends the signal, it just takes the pins from the connector and scale them into more pins that output a signal to the display. That probably won't make any sense, but anyway. So the Game Boy Advance, I can use perfectly with a flash card. I had this GBA flash card for a while, and it works perfectly well, I'll admit. Although, correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think these models were designed to have backlights. Or maybe it does, but the backlight's broken. I could still play games perfectly fine, it's just that it's a bit hard to see in dark places. So to show you that it works, I will bring in a light.
If I were to turn it on. As you can see, it works perfectly.
Although it doesn't really give me any light,
I actually don't mind.
As for the GameCube, I don't have any games for this thing yet. All I can really do is just boot into the main menu and change the clock, go through memory card data, and even... This is pretty much it. Although I could get an actual replay for this to play some homebrew or maybe even some emulators, I don't know. Although, if you remember Commander B. If you remember Computer Do 1995, who you may have seen in my 150 subspecial and my Me and the Boys playing Mario Kart gameplay, I went to his house. Well, actually, I go to his house all the time. Well, almost all the time. And he has a copy of Mario Golf World Tour. Not World Tour, actually. I think it's Toadstool Tour, but also, am I the only one that confuses Peach with Toadstool, even though they're the exact same character? I mean, I get their names confused, if that makes sense. So anyway, Gameboy Advance gets a 17 out of 20. 17 out of 20. It's good, it's just that the only way you can get a perfect 20 is with the backlight, which, again, I don't really mind, but... doesn't matter. As for the GameCube, I give it a question mark out of 10, because I can't give a full review on this without any games, so what the heck. So if you have any game suggestions for both the Game Boy Advance and the GameCube that you want me to play on my channel, let me know in the comments and I will be sure to play these eventually. Anyway, thank you for watching this video, it means a very lot to me, and if you'd like to check out Computer Do 1995, you can do so in the comments, I mean, description. Why did I say comments? So, anyway, thank you for watching this video, it means a very lot to me, I already said that, I know, but anyway, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, subscribe, comment, click the notification bell if you'd like. Again, check out Computer Do 1995 in the description. And that's all you have to do, so, goodbye!